The thing about annual grasses that alarms me is they didn't get here until the 1880s. And in 125 years, we have somewhere in the neighborhood of 80 million acres of rangeland in the western United States being influenced by annual grasses.
Know that we need to bring bunch grasses back into the picture if we're going to keep the ecological integrity that is important to people, to wildlife, to just maintaining a good natural balance in these systems. That restoration can learn a lot from the technologies that have already been used in agricultural settings and other, you know, technical and advanced ways to make a seed do more than just what it does naturally.
The one thing we know about climate is that it changes. If you look at temperature and moisture, to the extent that we become drier and hotter, if that happens, we're going to see an expansion in the range of annual grasses. What annual grasses have done is they've provided a continuous fuel bed. If you look at the sagebrush around us, you're going to see a lot of bare ground, and that bare ground represents a discontinuous fuel bed. If you fill it with annual grasses, continuous fuel bed. And so fires can travel much more easily across the landscape. When they do, you get more fire.
Invasive annual grasses have one job, and they do it really well, and that is to grow as fast as possible with whatever resources are available and make seeds.
That's a Medusa head seedling right there.
So this is the Medusa head seedling. It's the weed that we're trying to kill. And what you got here is the early blade that's already come out, plus the root from just this fall. So it probably germinated 2 weeks ago. And here's the sprint that it's already taken under.
Perennial bunch grasses, once they get big, once they have that big root system, they're our best defense against annual grasses. But getting them to that adult stage from the seed is where the challenge comes in.
So these are, they're small this year, I think because it's dry.
This is like our living laboratory. We are experimenting with different techniques of doing restoration and targeting them where we think they're going to be the most effective, and then really keeping an eye on them and learning from what we're doing, because not everything that we do works at the scale that we need them to. And so I think it's going to require innovation.
One of the best ways that we can combat annual grasses is through pre-emergent herbicides. The problem is it also means bad things for the perennials that we seed as well, because they need to come up through that same soil surface. So one solution historically has been to spray a pre-emergent herbicide and create a window in time when you have a relatively annual-free environment to seed into. However, when you've got fires that are measured in hundreds of thousands of acres, you're not going to have the time, money, and people power to go in twice. You got to get it done in one shot. So how do you do that?
Herbicide protection technology is a technology that uses activated carbon. It's often used to filter water or clean up chemical spills. And here we're using it for an application of basically protecting the seeds, allowing land managers to spray and then seed in the same year.
It does work. The basic premise of this new tool that we're developing, it's pretty solid. And we've tested that in the lab in the field. We know that it could help.
So what we're looking at is sort of the evolution of our herbicide protection technology. This is where we started. These are extruded pellets that were initially produced in-house using a modified pasta machine. And these are coated by an industry partner. The reason we went from in-house production to partnering with an industry was because scalability was much easier to achieve.
We probably don't have the money and equipment to go out and fix the whole of the sagebrush step. And I think that one of the things that's going to be critical as we move forward is that we focus our resources on areas that have the potential to be recovered. If we can see gains in a place like Juniper Hills Preserve, if we can begin to see gains using seed technologies, getting the needle pointed in the right direction is what success looks like.
We care about these systems. We care about the people that live here. We care about the wildlife that live here. And we can see that the trend is not good, and we want to intervene. And I want to see them return to health. and return to the potential I know that they have.